Hi you guys, welcome back to my platform and to my channel. Thank you for your likes, comments, subscriptions. Thank you guys for your support, your view. I be seeing y'all who be liking every single one of my videos, and of course it might be different people, but if you are continuously one of those people who are liking my videos and viewing it when it's out, I just want to say thank you. I do be seeing y'all and I'm so appreciative. I'm just so proud of us. Moment of silence. So, today we're going to talk music. I'm going to tell you guys about some of my favorite artists, especially women. And then, yeah, I'm going to put in some of their clips and stuff of their music. Hopefully, you guys get put onto new artists. And, of course, put me onto new artists. Let me know who y'all's artist is. I want to listen and hear new music. But it got to be good. It got to be good. So, yeah. I'm gonna start off with my favorite women rappers and artists, and then after that we're just gonna see where the video goes into and who I go into, and we gonna call it a motherfucking day. So please do not expect, I'm gonna let y'all know right now, I don't have Megan, I don't have Lotto, I don't have Flo Milli, I don't have none of those people on my list. Sorry, not sorry. A lot of those people were very good when they first came out, but then when they sold their soul, now all they do is rap about sex, and all they do when they're performing and stuff is twerking. I don't care anymore. Okay. So, when I'm looking and I'm into music and stuff, I like people who actually make music, make art, create, express, can rap, lyricists. You know, of course the twerking and stuff is fun, but come on now, you're not going to be my favorite rapper just to be twerking. I don't even be twerking. So, you know, but one of my favorite women artist that has been one of my favorite for a while would be Melly. She's from New York, she's Dominican, she speaks Spanish, come on now, bilingual. And she her music really just helped for me to feel I don't know, a lot of her music, she talks about the things that she has gone through, pain that she has gone through, breakups, loving herself, wanting to kill herself, depression, anxiety, but she also talks about healing. She talks about how she's growing and stuff like that. So I love her so much. She helps me to really kind of understand myself or just feel relatable, and her music is so sexy, and that's what I love about Melly. She's a vibe, she's just a vibe, and I feel like she's just such a girl's girl that her music, when other women and we listen to it, it's girl, 10 out of 10, you just said everything that be on my fucking mind. So yes, I love Melly. She's more of she's a rapper, but she also sings. So if you like singing rappers, and then she does translate from English to Spanish, back to English. But her music is so cool and it's such a vibe, and her beats are amazing. And then of course her lyrics, I just love how she flows. And her lyrics to me gives me poetry. I love it. The first song I heard by her was that See Me song that I believe, I'm not gonna say it blew up, but that's one of her biggest songs. And I was just oh my gosh, she bad, she fine, her body tea, and you make music and you write poetry. Girl, you got my vote, okay? So Melly has been one of my favorite women artists for a long time. She just doesn't drop as consistently, but it's okay. But I do love her, and when she does drop, she never fails me, no skips. Love her. Come here closer, let me hold ya. Let me tell you about the baddest bitches that I know. Never do no crying over hoes, we get the dough. Count that paper, watch it overflow. Throw it like a stripper, let it flow on through the floor, then pick it up. Is this no, baby, I can't even blame you, I'm a bad bitch. Give a fuck about your diamonds and your status. I get high. Time, yeah. Stuck in the days, but I got money on my mind, yeah. And if I'm walking in the room, yeah, your bitch be staring. Got you. My next, one of my favorite other rappers would be Detronada. She was on the Rap Game, I believe, season 2 or 3. But she was on the Rap Game. She is from Baltimore. And I got put onto her from the Rap Game. But I remember, during the Rap Game, I really loved how much she grew during the Rap Game, from growing her looks, growing her lyrics, and I love how much she just grew and learned on the Rap Game. And I was oh yeah, she's gonna be something, because she can rap. But she was so young already, like learning so much and perfecting and executing. I was like, oh yeah, she's gonna be something. But at the time when I actually listened to her music, I was like, this music is childish, which it kind of was. Obviously we're kids, you know. But now that I went back and listened to her catalog, I'm like, oh bitch, what the fuck have I been missing out all 2023? Because she was dropping all last year. I just now listened to it, but she, the bitch can rap. Rap. R-A-P. Rap. Straight rapping. I feel like she could rap for hours on hours on hours, months, years, decades. She can rap. She's one of those artists that when you listen to, you can tell, wow, this is her gift. This is her gift. She is doing exactly what the fuck she is meant to be doing. Because, bitch, ain't nobody doing it like her. I'm telling y'all. Listen to one of her projects. And her projects are not long either. I can tell you guys my favorite one. I think my favorite project would be, I think it's called Not a World 222. That's one of my favorite projects by her. Damn near no skips. And like I said, the bitch can rap. I'm sorry. She can rap. I don't care. Everybody always want to say something about, like, Baltimore rappers, but some Baltimore rappers are actually kind of good. Like, damn. Yes, they got accents and they be talking about shooting shit up and stuff. But, like, they can rap. Like, a lot of people in Baltimore had talent. But, yeah, she's one of my favorite, too. I absolutely love her. And hopefully we keep getting music from her, too. But she definitely gives me lyricists. And she gives me, like, she's actually for real rapper. Like, it's not for the money, not for the fame. It's just because she genuinely loves it. It's her gift. And that's what brings her calmness and peace and everything. So, like, yeah, I love her music.
That shit great. These niggas know I never had to do too much. I made more than a BBL. Cause fuck if I'm cute enough, can't focus, need to add a raw pop. And now I'm booted up. See, I could block your ass, so they pull on your block and shoot it up. I'm really hot, yeah, I just beat the shit about a Lucifer from BALTIMORE. I keep a Huey Tuck. All these bands to fix my crown. You was not my gang, you was not my cuz. See me in the club, don't piece me up. Reels I have, I do not sell doves. Do me a favor, don't say you in love. Yeah, I've been working, baby. How I feel, standing in the courtroom, alone in a bitch when you could've swore everybody around you real. Do you know how I feel? Talking to him one day, then the next day, phone call.
So yeah, and then, oh, Monalia, my gosh, pretty bitch Leo. I love Mana Leo. She's pretty. She got a husband and a kid. And she's still living her best life. She's still rapping, still looking good, still getting up, putting on for the rest of us bad bitches. Girl, I stand. Okay? But I love Mana Leo. I feel like she can rap too, and she's very clever with her raps, especially when it comes to like her punchlines. Like, it would be interesting if she ever made a diss track. Because her punchlines are really, really good. Like, and she's, like, so dainty and stuff. You wouldn't think she would be saying nothing. But then when you actually listen to her music, like, she actually be talking about fighting and, you know, stomping on people. I'm like, oh, I can get into this. Like, what you mean? You know what I'm saying? But, yeah. She is, I don't even know what to call her. I think she's a rapper. But she does have a song that she's saying. She does, I think she only has like one project out and then like singles, maybe an EP. But all her music also too just makes me feel good. And she also has music where she talks about, she's kind of versatile. Like she'll go from talking like about punching somebody, then go to talking about dogging a dude. But then she'll go to talking about like taking care of yourself, taking care of your mind. Being positive, and then of course her platform, she uses it for mental health as well to help other people who's dealing with depression and anxiety. So I just have to stand, like, the bitch is me, but she raps. I fucking stand. No, but seriously, I love artists who have like a bigger message or actually use their platform for a message. So I have to stand, Leo. Sorry, you that bitch. And yeah, I just really love her punchlines though. She like, she'll say shit that I feel like nobody else really be saying. Like, and yeah. But like I said, she only has one project out. It's pretty quick though, so I don't know. But her project made me fall in love with her more because she, like I said, is versatile and she has other things on there. She talks about her story. She talks about love, her man, her bait. Like, she's beautiful. I'm sorry. I have to stand a beautiful woman.
Again. but I'd rather go to space with no spacesuit. If it means that I won't get to face you.
Online, we thought it was funny, we know it's nothing. Wherever I see you is where you gon' lay. Better have you a strap, cause you know I'm clutching. Ayy, I don't have beef with none of these bitches. These hoes not my opps. If the law see a clip with sticks and beams, know them is not my props. Cause we got Drake's AR-15s, knock a bitch out her socks. Stand over a bitch and empty the clip till it click. I'm not gon' stop. Ayy, hoes only hard on Instagram, bitch, cut that live off. Hoes be thinking they queen bee till I come knock they whole damn hive off. Cause I pull up to a rat bitch hood and spray the whole block, then drive off.
And so, yeah, but those are like my top three. I also do like Anicia, who is new, maybe, on the scene. I believe she is new. But I do like Anicia. I feel like her punch. I love her punchlines too. And she gives me the same thing. Like, she just a pretty bad bitch who be high all day and just want to make music for other pretty bad bitches. Hello. Right here. I'm here. Okay. But no, I feel like her punchlines, like even her raps and her bars are different and like make sense. And especially if you are a pretty girl, you know. You gonna sit there, you gonna understand it. You gonna be like, oh, she right. And then she does have like really good ad-libs, and her voice and everything definitely makes everything just better and a breath of fresh air.
I'm Nini, he know I'm a dog. I'm Nini, he know I'm a bitch. I'm Nini, he know that I come with a stick. Bitch be hating, I know that I'm rich. This bitch know that I'm wealthy.
I feel like all the artists that I named, they're just such breaths of fresh air for me. It's like, oh, okay, I can see you in the lane, but you still in your own lane. Like, I feel like the Megans and the Lottos, they're just in the lane, and they're all just passive versus like Anicia, Manalio, Melly, DiTornada. It's like they're in the lane, but they got their own little detours. So, yeah. Let's see. I do love JT, but as we know, she does not have a project out yet. I'm very interested to listen to her project, though, her solo project, because I feel like in City Girls, she was the better rapper, but still, I feel like, as we all know, City Girls and JT and Young Miami only got together because JT wanted to be a rapper for real, for real, for real. That's why JT low-key is the better rapper, because that's her thing that she wanted to do. But she didn't want to do it by herself, so she ended up at the, I believe she asked one person, they said no, and then she asked Young Miami. Young Miami was like, okay. And then they ended up making City Girls. They ended up blowing up, and yeah. But JT is actually a rapper too, if you know her story. Like, I feel like she's been rapping for a minute, but she actually can rap too, and it's the same thing. Pretty bitch lyrics, and I'm all for it, girl. I want to be outside listening to your music for the night. I'm pretty than a healthy looking, okay? Okay, girl, I'm down. So yeah, I believe that's like five rappers right there. Women. I'm trying to think. There's nobody else, really. And you know what's crazy? I want to get put on to like more women R&B. Because, I don't know, I feel like R&B is making a little comeback. And I don't know, I just want to, like, I miss the Alicia Keys and the Keisha Coles. And I feel like there's definitely women out there like that. But I'm just not put on to them. And I don't like her. Kalani. I don't know. It just don't be giving me, like, I'd still be needing something else. I don't know. So yeah. And as you guys know, when it comes to men or males, I'm just like, I'm into Rod Wave. I love Tuzi. Well, Tuzi kind of prolonged his stay. So, but I love Rod Wave. I just got put onto Four Bats by my sister and my boyfriend. So I love him too. I feel like he has an R&B sound that I like. Or it's like a cool R&B sound. It really is like a vibing just type of R&B for real, for real, for real. So I love that. I love Party. Y'all already know P4, 10 out of 10. 10 out of 10. Party. I know. And you know what's crazy? Y'all always want to talk about somebody's album cover as if the album cover is not the album cover for a reason. This is what I be saying. Read a book, okay? Hip hop is... This is going to be the last thing I'm going to say, and then I'm going to wrap this video up because it's not even supposed to be about this. But hip hop was created as a form of expression. And hip hop really, 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 really was created back in New York as a means of keeping people and young people. I was gonna say boys, but I don't think it was just boys, but mainly young boys, because the young boys were getting into gangs, they were outside on the streets getting killed. So hey, but you know, for young people to come together and to have a form of expression that's not being in a gang. So they made hip-hop so that people can, you know, kind of go into hip-hop more, come together more, da da da. I say that to say that these white people, like I say, have y'all fucking brainwashed. Everybody was like, yeah, why is that party's album cover? Why is that party's album cover? Because it's hip-hop. This is his music. He can express, he can do what he wants. I know y'all saw Tupac's album cover, the one that was originally supposed to be, and Diddy was on there with his ass out. That's hip-hop. I think people have this thought of hip-hop. That's not hip-hop. You have the thought of hip-hop of what white people made it. But hip-hop, honestly, truly, it has always been an explicit. It has always been ruthless. It has always been not for the weak. So, yes, some album covers we will not like, and some album covers will be out there. But nobody gives a fuck. It's the artist's work. But I say that to say, Party, I'm happy that you proved people wrong, because people was definitely going too hard on that album cover. But I'm happy that you came out and you showed us what the fuck was up. A real bad man, you know what I'm saying? No, but for real, y'all. And by the way, the only reason why they have even explicit things, or like they can only do certain things and lanes and stuff like that, if y'all didn't know, like I say, and you don't even have to read a book, there's literally documentaries on this, but yeah. The only reason why they did that was because they had saw that artists, especially down south artists, once rap moved down south, they, and even down south artists, they were more freaky, dicky, leaky, sucky wucky, you know what I'm saying? It was like that, but still, like I said, they could do that, it's music, whatever. But once they had kind of saw a parent, white parents, when their kids started listening to those things, and white parents were just like, oh my gosh, this is you know, when the white parents did that, basically, and the white parents were complaining and all that, that's when they went to court, and it was some rapper, I forgot his name, but even he went to court. They were trying to say that he, I think they're honestly trying to put him in jail, for real, trying to say that his music was too explicit, that kids were listening to it. Once again, please raise your kids and stop letting celebrities and artists do it for you. But yeah, so they ended up going to court, and then he basically won because he was saying, like, this is freedom of expression. Is that not in the Constitution? So now artists do have to put that little explicit thing. That's their way of doing it now, so that people know. But yeah, music is music. Hip-hop is hip-hop. It's a form of expression and poetry. Let people express. If you don't like it, it's cool, because guess what? There's a search bar on all of these platforms for you to look up the artists that you fuck with. So thank you. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk. Y'all know I gotta put a little education and shit in there. But yeah, I love you guys. Please continue putting yourself first and enjoying the summer. Y'all, there's hella fucking bugs where I'm at. Like, I ain't never been in a place where there's this many big ass bugs and bugs flying from here to here. Honey, I love you, summer, but I don't know. These bugs is real, though. I ain't never seen no bugs like this. So yeah, enjoy your summer. Love you guys. Take care of yourself. Bye.